Crimean War artillery was as impressively diverse as the war itself. Ancient and modern, Eastern and Western, sometimes full of ornamentation, and sometimes stark, brutal, and devastating. In the field, bronze smoothbore cannons rolled into battle just as they had with Napoleon. Along the shores, cannons sometimes hundreds of years old stood guard over Constantinople. And yet also, on both land and sea, new shell guns fired massive bombs over tremendous distances, causing untold destruction. And all the new weapons of war that a fully industrialized Britain and France could muster rained shot and shell on the Russian foe. But seeing the stalemate of siege warfare in the Crimea, this mortar was designed to be the mortar of all mortars.
Now, we didn't get here before darkness fell, but hopefully you can still see this. This is Mallet's mortar, and this was designed during the Crimean War in 1854 as a 36-inch shell gun. This is a mortar that fires a shell that's 1 yard across. And it would have fired that shell nearly 3,000 yards. Absolutely incredible piece of machinery. It would have been able to be taken apart and reassembled in different places. Palmerston approved the project, but it was never used in war. This was actually tested by the Royal Artillery. There's another one at Fort Nelson, which was never fired at all. This is an absolutely incredible piece of mid-Victorian military technology, but it was never realized as a weapon of war.
Robert Mallet was an Irish engineer and geologist, not regularly involved in military circles. But throughout the 1850s, he was working on blasting experiments for geological purposes, and presumably that gave him the idea to make an earth-shattering mortar. Today, he's often referred to as the father of seismology, but we know him for that glorious representation of Victorian technology, attempting to solve the world's problems with steel, cast iron, and gunpowder. Mallet's mortar. For more glorious cannons and obscure history, be sure to like this video and subscribe to the Ministry for History.